of the scholars would say that the religion is can be divided into two words that would sum up the whole religion: sabr and shukr, thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and having patience. It's all about it. You have to be patient for all these years, waiting for the time that you are going to die and meet with Allah and get the reward from Allah subhanahu. It's all about shukr and sabr, which is something very good. I see Hajj really is the embodiment of Islam. All the lessons that we learn from Hajj, you can say that it's just Islam. If the word Islam means surrender and submission and obeying Almighty Allah. You see, the tawaf that we do had been done by Ibrahim alayhi salam. The call, and the people, everybody is saying, labbaik Allahumma labbaik. I'm responding to you, Allah. I'm responding to you. Yes, they are responding to the call that had been made by Ibrahim alayhi salam more than 2,000 years ago, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him to make the call for people. There were no humans around him. He was by himself. And he didn't have these microphones or these kinds of technology, but he has the Lord of technology. Yes. He has the Lord of the whole universe. He's right. The one who commanded him. And this is another lesson, indirect lesson, that you can learn. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks anything to happen, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands any messenger to do anything, it will happen. Definitely. You can see that at that time there was no human being to respond to him, and you can see the millions of people coming from every corner in the world. وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا وَعَلَى كُلِّ ضَامِرٍ يَأْتِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ فَجٍّ عَمِيقٍ لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ. Just make the call. Just make the call. Ibrahim alayhi salam, some people nowadays, they just fall into the trap of the shaitan. They just want to argue and question. You question Allah, he's the one who created the heavens and the earth.
Right.
You question the ability of Allah. And that's why when you recite the Quran, every time you find these ayat reinforcing these meanings in your heart, so you know that he is capable. Just do your job and Allah will do it. How? Don't ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This question of asking Allah, how are you going to do that? It's not, does not befit the majesty of Allah. Allah la yus'alu amma yaf'al. He is not asked about what he does. وَهُمْ يُسْأَلُونَ. They are the ones to be asked, but not the Lord, their Lord. So here, you can find that the response. So once he submitted, Ibrahim alayhi salam, he submitted to the command of Allah without using his mind illogically, because that's what people do now. I mean, I just get my salary, which is the $300. How can I live my life? This is not your job. You do the work, you go to work, and you will find the risk coming to you, because the risk does not come from your job. Does not that work? The risk comes from Almighty Allah. You buy a car that stays with you 30 years, and I buy a car, and after 3 years, it's gone. This is risk from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The good risk, and so on and so forth. Right. So this is one lesson that we learn from Ibrahim. The same lesson we learn from the son of Ibrahim, Ismail alayhi salam, when he, yes, was led by his father to be slaughtered, the place where he's supposed to be slaughtered, he said, Ya abati, if'al ma tu'mar, do what you are commanded by Allah to do. Satajiduni insha'Allah min al-sabiri. This is a child, 9 years old, around that time. He is teaching us the same lesson of Ibrahim. Just submit to the will of Allah. The child learns nobody loves to be killed. And while he is in this situation, he used the beautiful words with his father. Oh my beloved father. Not just oh my father. Oh my beloved father, I love you. I know that you are going to slaughter me, yet I love you. Because I know that this command is not according to your desire or wish, but it is something that you have been commanded to do by Allah. And if it is from Allah, I surrender myself to the command of Allah. Beautiful, beautiful. It's the same lesson. How to be a Muslim and surrender yourself to the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without having these nonsense debates and discussion. The same thing happened from the wife of Ibrahim. Right. When he left her there, she asked him, are you doing this out of your own thinking and desire? He said, no. Allah amaraka bihada. Did Allah command you to do this? Ya Ibrahim, to ask me to stay in Mecca with no humans around me, with no food and no water? He said, yes. She said, idan la yudayyuna. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never fail us, will never lose us, will always support us. Full submission to Allah. And yet, with the submission and the belief of Allah, and this is something that's missing from some Muslims here, is the actions. You have to do your part. You have to do your action. So she started looking for the food and looking for the water, going here and going there, going to this mountain one time, two times, three times. She never knew when the victory of Allah has come.
Right.
But came after seven times. It's the same lesson of submitting yourself to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.